This is an assembly and use video of the Best Wave X closed column extractor dewaxing. This is our closed column extractor, but this one has a dewaxing sleeve on it. The dewaxing sleeve is a sleeve on the outside of the main material column. The sleeve is intended for dry ice. This system, I'm going to disassemble it real quick. You guys can see all the parts that come in it. So we have our bottom valve with a barb on it. We have our 150 micron mesh screen. We've got our material column that'll mount together. Just slide these together real quick. There we go. There's a single pin clamp with a hinge on the bottom. You're just gonna tighten that as tight as you can with your hand. And if you want, you can stick a screwdriver in there and just give it another half turn. Make sure it's nice and snug. At this point, you got the column assembled the way that you need it to be. So at this point, what you want to do, we have a couple of different options. Right now, the system's assembled with a 150 mesh screen. It works really, really well, but some people want additional filtration. We have ashless filter papers, and you can also use any of the unbleached coffee filters. So what we'll do is we might have a piece that we want to put down at the bottom of the tube. So we can pack that down in there before we start putting our material on it to assist us with additional filtration. What I'm using here is a packing rod that we sell. It's an a la carte item. It doesn't come with the extractor. It has a rubber gasket on it, because after you put the paper in there, you might want to start packing your material in there. This thing will allow you to have a really nice pack on your material. Okay, so assuming that we have this thing all filled up and ready to go, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put our top cap on. I wanna note, the normal system that you see online comes with a top cap, looks a little bit more like this, okay? Top cap has a flat bottom, valve, and a barb on it. It's very simple. The one I'm using here is the fully upgraded one. It has a spray ball on the bottom, a sight glass, the gauge, and obviously your valve and your flare at the top. The spray ball at the bottom is nice because it helps disperse the solvent, so you don't end up just burning a hole straight through the center core of it. The other thing is too, the sight glass is nice because you can see the solvent moving into the system, so you can actually monitor it. And you can know when you can't put any more into it or nothing else is flowing. The gauge is nice too because you'll be able to tell that you have a full vacuum on it. The other thing is you'll be able to monitor pressure. These things are under pressure, so it's nice to know if there is any pressure in the system before you open it. Okay, so next step, you put on your gasket and you put your top cap on it. And at this point, I'd also like to make a note. So some customers, they are concerned that they might pull material when they hook up their vacuum pump to this through the top because there's some filtration. If you want to add filtration, you can. Again, laboratory paper, unbleached coffee filter on top, then close it up. You want to make sure you don't have any paper or anything hanging over on the gasket. The gasket needs to make contact with both stainless interfaces in order for it to work properly. Okay. So we have our material column filled, our filtration in place. The next step, what we're going to do is we're going to add the dry ice to the column. So what you're going to do is you're going to take a brick of dry ice, or if you have pelletized dry ice, that's great, it doesn't matter. You break it up, you can use a paper plate, or you can use a cup, and you can actually help funnel that into this, into the outside jacket here. Then you're going to let that jacket sit for about 30 minutes. Prior to that though, you want to pull a vacuum on the system, and I'll show you how to do that real quick. You're gonna hook this up. Of course, we got our gauge here. Close the bottom valve, make sure the top one's open, turn on your vacuum pump. This column's very small, so it only takes a moment to pull it in vacuum. You check your gauge to make sure you pull it all the way down. Close your valve before you turn off the pump, disconnect your pump. So the system's under vacuum. Now you can just let it sit. It's super frosty over the next 30 minutes before you go into your next step. All right, so next step, what you're gonna do is start adding your solvent. So we have our material column that's super frosty, the material in there is super cold right now, and you're gonna grab a can tip adapter. As you guys are familiar with the can tip adapters, they come with the solvent cans. Choose the one that most appropriately fits the inside of the flare up here that you would insert your can and put your solvent in. But before that, I'm going to explain a couple other things that you can do. We have stainless steel hoses that we sell for a lot of our systems. They will hook up. This is a quarter inch hose. This is a quarter inch flare. You can hook up this hose to any of our solvent tanks that we sell. The fittings on the solvent tank will fit right onto this hose, so it's all turnkey for you. You don't need additional parts or fittings. You won't have to go to the store. The other alternative is our can tap tool. Our can tap tool would hook up to the end of the hose just like this. Remember, when you're tightening these connections, don't do it by hand. You want to do it with a wrench. You want to make sure it's a nice tight connection. These are all 316 grade fittings. They're precision cut. They're going to seal every time. Leaks don't happen with these hoses. They're very, very good hoses. They're all bench tested. They're made very well. And their interfaces are really, really machined with a precision finish, so that they're always going to mate properly for you. Okay, so the can tap tool, the way that it's designed, you would put a can into the system, into the tool, and then you would puncture the side of it, and then your solvent will go through the line and into your column. Can tap tool is a nice alternative if you don't have access to tip adapters for your cans. So this is an alternative. Not the greatest solution, most people have access to it, but it is a solution that's out there, so if you are stuck with cans that you can't use, at least you got an alternative. Okay, so back to the can. And we'll use this tip adapter here. So what you're gonna do at this point is, I'm gonna orient this so you can see it. The sight glass here is gonna help us know that the solvent's moving into the system. What you're gonna do is you're gonna depress the can, you got a seal, there's no leak, and then you're gonna open the valve, and then the solvent's gonna start running into the system. You're gonna see it in the sight glass as I just showed you. After you completely empty the can, or you get to a point where the can won't fill anymore, you're done, essentially. What's gonna happen is, at some point, the pressure inside the can is gonna equal the pressure inside the column, and you won't be able to put any more in after that. But because it is a de-waxing column, there's one advantage that you have. The advantage is the solvent that's in there is gonna be very, very cold. Liquid storage temperature of most of the solvents that we use is about 31.6 degrees. So since this is going to be pushing itself closer to like minus 20, minus 30 degrees, you're going to be able to put more solvent in this type of system than you would a normal system. And that's because the gas that's inside there is not being allowed to expand. So after the solvent's in the system, you can let it soak for a predetermined amount of time. We have recommendations of usually like 7 to 10 minutes. I do have customers that let it soak for 40. I've heard of people letting it soak for an hour. You're gonna have to play with it a little bit, kind of dial it into the to the amount of time that you want it to steep inside the column. The other thing is too, you have a pressure gauge too. The pressure gauge will also help you kind of indicate how much pressure is in the column. And you'll notice that when you have a de-waxing column, the pressure is gonna be very, very low, obviously because there's no temperature to help that gas expand.